السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. Inshallah, we will continue with the subject of patience and perseverance as we are, inshallah, studying from the book of Riyadh al-Salihin and how the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam touch every single aspect of our life and teach the Muslim how to lead a very respectful life and a life that will make him pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be also contented and satisfied with his life, achieving success in this world and the hereafter. We talked about some ahadith last time with regard to patience and perseverance. And the one that we have today is actually narrated by Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhum. He was Hibb Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the son of Zayd ibn Haritha, and he was considered as one of the most beloved people to the heart of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He narrated that one of the daughters of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ibnat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, arsalat ilayhi, she sent a message to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that inna ibni qad ihtidara fashhadna. She said that her son is dying and she wanted the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be there, to be present during this time, to give her condolences and to see what is going to do during these last moments of this child. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent her a messenger giving her the salam, and he said to her, لِلَّهِ مَا أَعْطَى وَلِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذَ وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمِقْدَارٍ فَالْتَصْبِرِي وَالْتَحْتَسِبِي أَوْ فَالْتَصْبِرْ وَالْتَحْتَسِبْ. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent her a message saying that to Allah what he gives and to Allah what he takes and everything is decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so be patient and seek the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is the ta'ziyah, or this is the condolences that a Muslim should give to the Muslim when he when someone dies and you're giving condolences or the ta'ziyah, you say لِلَّهِ مَا أَعْطَى وَلِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذَ وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِمِقْدَارٍ أَوْ بِأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. Everything is decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it has a specified and fixed and appointed term by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so be patient and seek the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal. Then his daughter sent to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam requesting him to come. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went with Sa'd ibn Ubadah wa Mu'ad ibn Jabal and Ubay ibn Ka'b wa Zayd ibn Thabit. So he took some of his companions and went to his daughter. And when the child was given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the narrator said, أَقْعَدَهُ فِي حِجْرِهِ وَنَفْسُهُ تُقَعْقِعْ. He said he made the child, they said, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carried the child and his breath was actually being disturbed in his chest. Then at this moment, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started crying. The tears came out of his eyes. فَسَعَدْ بْنُ عُبَادَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ يَقُولُ لَهُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ what is this? Yani he was wondering that why are you crying? Why tears are coming out of your eyes? And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, هذه رحمة جعلها الله في قلوب عباده. I mean, even the Messenger of Allah, even the Messenger of Allah, he has a heart like anyone. His heart gets like, I mean, he's the most compassionate heart. Subhanallah العظيم. يعني if the person does not get like really affected by the death and does not like learn the lesson and get like really impacted and impressed by it, subhanallah, what else is left? So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of that situation, the tears came out of his eyes. And Sa'd ibn Ubadah was wondering, O Messenger of Allah, was this why you are crying? Then he said, this is a mercy, this is a compassion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in the heart of his servants, in the hearts of his servants. And in another narration he said, في قلوب من شاء من عباده وإنما يرحم الله من عباده الرحماء. He said, this is a mercy and a compassion that Allah places in the hearts of his servants, of those that he wills from his servants, and Allah will bestow his mercy upon those who are merciful. When the person has kindness, compassion, and has mercy, then he is guaranteed the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now we see in this hadith how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is consoling and giving condolences to his daughter and asking her, requesting her to be patient and at the same time to seek the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for her patience. The other hadith is a little bit longer and I will inshallah delay it because it needs like a special session. It talks about a whole story, and this story is mentioned in the Quran, by the way, in Surah Al-Buruj, Was-Sama'idat Al-Buruj, is the story about that little boy that the king had taken him and want to teach him magic. Inshallah, we will talk about this story in detail and many lessons, great lessons that we learn from this story. But the other hadith that we have, inshallah, tonight is about the women. And this is like really a test for the Muslim. When the Muslim is hit with the first disaster, with the first shock in his life, this is actually the real test. So this woman seemed that she lost a very beloved person to her heart. Yani, some of the narrations said that it was like her son or her brother, someone that she loved the most. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, as Anas ibn Malik رضي الله تعالى عنه narrated, he said, مر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بامرأة تبكي عند قبر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed by a woman who was crying at a grave. Passing by a woman crying at a grave, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave his recommendation, telling the woman, اتق الله واصبري. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient. يعني, yes, it's okay to cry, but it seems that the woman was not only crying. She was crying in a way that shows like, non-acceptance of Allah's decree and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed for her. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to her, اتق الله واصبري. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be patient. فهي لا تعرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. She did not know that this was the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقالت له, إليك عني. I mean, stay away from me. فإنك لم تصب بمصيبتي. You did not have the same disaster as I have. You don't have the same feeling that I have right now. And it's true. Like the one who is in the, like suffering from the crisis or the disaster or the hardship or the problem is, يعني, subhanAllah, his feeling is completely different from other people. Yes, someone has a hardship, has a problem, has a crisis. We might go to this person and try to say good words to him. We'll try to help the person. But definitely every one of us who is giving condolences and is trying to comfort this person, definitely our feelings are not like the feeling of this person. يعني, we have a saying in Arabic, it says, الذي يده في الماء ليس كالذي يده في النار. من يده في النار ليس كالذي يده في الماء. يعني the one whose hand is in the fire is not like the one whose hand is in the water. It's completely different. So she said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إليك عني فإنك لم تصب بمصيبتي. You are not, have, you have been inflicted, you have not been inflicted with the same disaster that I have. ولم تعرفني. Then later on she was informed that this is the Messenger of Allah. فقيل لها إنه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. سبحان الله. She came to the house of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's the leader of the Muslims, the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet, subhanAllah, the most honored and respected person by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of Allah's creation. And subhanAllah, he does not have a gatekeeper. He doesn't have a doorkeeper. He doesn't have someone even to organize the people to enter upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the way, organized this by himself. Because people used to go all the time and ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and like they go all the time. It's very crowded. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala organized this, by the way, in Surah Al-Mujadila. يعني, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them, فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نَاجَيْتُمُ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَطْهَرٌ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So in order to organize it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you want to have a private conversation with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I mean, don't pay him. You're not going to pay him. But what you need to do, give a charity. يعني, help someone who is in need of help. قَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقًا ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَأَطْهَرٌ. This is better for you and is purer for you. فَإِن لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. If you don't have anything to give in a charity, then Allah is forgiving and merciful. But there is another alternative. فَإِن لَمْ تَجِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And then he said, أَأَشْفَقْتُمْ أن تقدموا بين يدي نجواكم صدقات، فإذ لم تفعلوا وتاب الله عليكم فأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأطيعوا الله ورسوله والله خبير بما تعملون. So if you cannot give in a charity, so at least what you need to do, pray. دو تركعة الله سبحانه وتعالى. So when they pray, they start taking some time and they start being organized. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it to happen this way. So anyway, she came to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and she didn't see any gatekeeper or any doorkeeper. لم تجد عنده بوابين. And she is apologizing for what she said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya Rasulullah, lam a'rifk. I didn't know that you are the one who was talking to me. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said a very beautiful statement to her. He said, إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. And this is true, my dear brothers and sisters. Real patience comes at the first disaster that hits. This is the real test for the Muslim. Might be living all his entire life, everything is good, no problem, no sickness, no disease, no death, no disaster, nothing happened to his money, nothing happened to his children, nothing happened to his family, everything is absolutely fine. But once the first disaster hits, this is the real test. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ. There are some people that worship Allah on an edge. يعني they are about to fall. Like they are worshiping Allah as long as everything is good. They pray, they fast, they give in a church, they read Quran as long as they have no problem. Once a problem happened to them, as if this is the end of the world. Maybe they stop praying. Oh, my prayer is not doing anything to me. It's not benefiting me. My charity is not doing anything. Why I'm doing all this? In asabahu khairun min nabi. As long as everything is okay, he's okay with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When asabatuhu fitna, if a test hits him, if he's being tested with anything, inqalaba ala wajhihi khasir al-dunya wal-akhirah, dhalika huwa al-khusran al-mubin. That's not the way that the Muslim should be. The Muslim should bear with patience and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help him in his problem and in his disaster. That's why there is another hadith narrated by Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, yaqulu Allah ta'ala, ma li'abdi al-mu'min indi jaza'un idha qabattu safiyahu min ahli al-dunya thumma ihtasabahu illa al-jannah. The message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as narrated by Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that Allah, this is now a hadith Qudsi. This is a sacred hadith from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have no reward other than Jannah for a believing servant of mine who remains patient for my sake when I take away his beloved one from among the inhabitants of the world. يعني subhanallah, when the Muslim loses a beloved family member, someone that is very dear and very beloved to him, and he is patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and you are patient, and you seek the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that, and you say, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is no reward for him except Jannah. And what a beautiful reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for this person. Even when there is a pandemic, or there is like a contagious disease, the Islamic etiquette is, if it happens in a place, and the Muslim is in this place, he's not supposed to go out. And people outside the place should not come in. And this is what they call the lockdown, which they did in the beginning. Yes, that was actually an Islamic principle, actually, to follow and to contain the disease. It's an Islamic principle, actually, from the beginning. إذا وقع الطاعون بأرض وأنتم فيها فلا تخرجوا منها وإن لم تكونوا فيها فلا تدخلوها. If the ta'un or the pandemic happened in a place and you are in this place, don't go out because you are going to give it to other people to spread it. And if you are out, don't come to this place. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as narrated by Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, سألت عن الطاعون. She asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the ta'un. Ta'un is the plague, or we can say the pandemic, or what happened with the coronavirus. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked about this contagious disease. فأخبرها أنه كان عذابا يبعثه الله تعالى على من يشاء. He said it used to be a punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent against the past nations, those who disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disobeyed him. فجعله الله تعالى رحمة للمؤمنين. So it was a punishment for the disbelievers, but when it happens to the people and it happened to the believers, So it is a mercy for the believers. It takes away from his sins and his mistakes. That again does not mean that the Muslim will not protect himself. And the Muslim will not wear the mask and will not take all the precautionary actions to and measures to in order to protect himself and protect his health and the health of others. But it means that after taking all the precautionary measures and after protecting himself and by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it happened to him and he died. So it's a mercy, or he is being inflicted with it and subhanallah, he suffered for some time. This is taking away from his sins. So the Prophet ﷺ said, it is actually a mercy to the believers. فَلَيْسَ مِنْ عَبْدٍ Listen to what the Prophet ﷺ said. فَلَيْسَ مِنْ عَبْدٍ يَقَعُ فِي الطَّاعُونَ فَيَمْكُثُ فِي بَلَدِهِ صَابِرًا مُحْتَسِبًا يَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ لَا يُصِيبُهُ إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ إِلَّا كَانَ لَهُ مِثْلُ أَجْرِ شَهِيدٍ رواه البخاري. The Prophet ﷺ said, there is no servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anyone who remains in a town which is plagued with the pandemic and maintaining patience, expecting the reward from Allah and knowing that nothing will ever happen to him, nothing will befall him other than what Allah has foreordained or decreed for him, he would receive a reward of the shaheed, the martyr, subhanallah al-azim. So following the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, staying in the place, being patient, protecting himself and others, that is going to be the reward of the shaheed if something ever happened to this person. In another hadith, subhanallah, narrated by al-Bukhari, that Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, also this is all about patience. Qala, sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the sahabi says, this is according to the science of hadith, ilm al-hadith. When the sahabi says, I hear the messenger of Allah, this is the strongest degree of the hadith. This is the most authentic one. Because he heard it directly from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whom we're talking about? Anas ibn Malik, the one who used to be with the Prophet ﷺ day and night, serving the Prophet ﷺ for 9 years. He said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ قَالْ إِذَا إِبْتَلَيْتُ عَبْدِي بِحَبِيبَتَيْهِ فَصَبَرَ عَوَّضْتُهُ مِنْهُمَا الْجَنَّةِ حَبِيبَتَيْهِ يعني عينيه. يعني if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as narrated by this, in this hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah the glorious and exalted said in the hadith Qudsi, when I afflict my servant in his two dear things. What are the two dear things? His eyes. Meaning that if someone lost the vision or the eyesight and he is patient and seeking the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my reward will be the Jannah. I will conclude with this hadith. It's amazing that this woman, subhanallah, one day Ata ibn Rabah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, yaqulu, qala li ibn Abbas, يعني ابن عباس رضي الله عنه ست عطاء ابن رباح. ابن عباس من الصحابة وعطاء ابن رباح من التابعين. قال ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى بس ابن عباس يعني أدرك التابعين لأنه كان من صغار الصحابة. He was a cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم but was still a young child. So he happened to be with the following generation. So عطاء ابن رباح رضي الله تعالى عنه said قال لي ابن عباس. يقول ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه said to me ألا أريك امرأة من أهل الجنة؟ Should I show you a woman from the residence of Jannah, from the dwellers of Jannah, a woman that is guaranteed Jannah? قال بلى. He said, yes, show me this woman. قال, this woman, هذه المرأة, أتت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, فقالت, she came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and she said, O Messenger of Allah, إني أسرع, وإني أتكشف. السرع هو المرض الذي يجعل الإنسان يفقد وعيه ويقع مغمى عليه. هو ما يسمى ب epilepsy, الصرع. فقالت يا رسول الله إني أصرع, I have been inflicted with epilepsy, and when it happens to me, I don't know what's going on with me, and because I don't know anything. يعني I get like I lost my consciousness, and what happens? يعني my body gets like exposed. وإني أتكشف. فادعوا الله لي. He said, O Messenger of Allah, make dua for me that Allah relieves this from me. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن شئت صبرت ولك الجنة وإن شئت دعوت الله أن يعافيك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave her the option. He said, if you want, you can be patient, take it with patience, continue with it, and you will have Jannah, your promised Jannah. Or if you want, I can make dua for you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it away from you. The lady said, I will choose Jannah. She said, oh, Messenger of Allah, I will be patient and I want Jannah. Subhanallah. She could have taken the other option and she will still go to Jannah, but she want from the mouth of the Prophet ﷺ. She wants a word from the Prophet ﷺ, from his tongue, to saying that you're going to Jannah. She said, I will take the second choice. Make dua for me, the first choice. I will be patient. But, O Messenger of Allah, I have a request. Can you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever it happens to me that my body will not be exposed? Yani, I will be completely covered with my clothes. The women want to keep her chastity, honor, and dignity. And subhanallah, the Prophet ﷺ made dua for her. And it used to happen to her. After that, this epilepsy, the sara', and she was never exposed. Subhanallah al-Azim. By the blessing of the dua of the Prophet ﷺ, wal-hadithu muttafaqud alayhi, rawahu al-Bukhari wa Muslim. There are some ahadith in this chapter of patience. Very beautiful ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ. Nas'alullah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yahabana as-sabra fi al-umur kulliha. Yani, really, we need patience in every single aspect of our life. We need patience over the temptations, over the fitan, over like... to help us with the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help us stay from the disobedience of Allah azza wa jal. We need patience in every single aspect of our life. I don't think any day can pass by the Muslim and he is not in need of patience. This is the subject that we need really to practice and to do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَنْ يَجْعَلَنَا مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَالصَّابِرَاتِ. Those who are patient from the men and those who are patient from the women, that Allah promised them maghfira wa ajrun azim, which is the forgiveness and the great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afafa wa al-ghina wa min al-amal ma tarda bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa sattur uyubana wa shrah sudurana wa balighna mimma yurtika amalana wa sallillahumma wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk wal asr. إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.